This sode would not be possible without the support of our listeners, patrons, and sponsors. If you'd like to learn more about supporting the 3-Bit Gamer Show, check us out on Patreon at patreon.com/3BG. And a huge thanks goes out to our boss-level patrons, Christopher and Patrick.
Hey, guys, let me in. It's sick out here.
No! I saw you wipe your nose, you liar!
I have an itchy nose. You know that!
The only thing I know is that you never wash your hands after you pee!
It's not like I pee on my hands.
You are not coming in. Find another shelter.
You sick rat bastard! Go wash your hands first! Sing happy birthday at least twice!
Okay, just let me in first, and I'll wash my hands inside.
He's not coming in.
No, there's no way we're letting him in. He's super gross, and I don't even like him that much anyway.
For real. Good luck, Peterson!
No!
Welcome to the 3-Bit Gamer Show. I'm JD.
This is Peterson.
And Danny.
And get ready for a lot more scripted content.
Are we doing all radio plays now?
That's the whole show now. That's what we do.
We're slowly evolving.
Live from the 3-Bit Gamer Show. The news. All right, our news this week is brought to us by Crave Cookies. Crave Cookies is this awesome little cookie pretzel soda shop down here in Salt Lake City in Midvale, Utah. They also have DoorDash and other delivery opportunities and options. And what's really awesome about Crave, other than the fact that they sponsor this show, is that every week they have a fancy new cookie of the week.
Did you see the one this week?
Oh my gosh.
Yep.
Oh my god.
I'm thinking about going and getting one after this.
I will describe it first and then I'll tell you what it's called because I don't want to spoil it. A vanilla dough base stuffed with fruity pebbles and just the right amount of white chocolate. We roll the dough in even more fruity pebbles and finish it with a cream cheese frosting.
I'm in.
It is the Flintstone.
Yep.
Oh,
my God.
This is like a cookie just covered with fruity pebbles.
Yeah, dude. It's the confetti cookie. Like, it's just got all the flavors. So if you haven't had a chance to check out Crave, check them out. They are the best. All right. Peter. Oh, man. Our news is interesting this week. Okay, so this one is kind of a small story, but I think it's kind of funny just because of the property in the company. So this was posted on the FIFA subreddit that somebody posted in some, some EA European-related subreddit or something, looking for people to help them scout teams in that native country. There, it is, what is this called? Alsvenskan? I don't know what that is.
You just made that up. He acted like he was reading something. He was not. Because he's not even looking at his screen. He was just saying things.
Alsvenskan okay, is a Swedish professional league for men's associate football clubs. So basically EA was reaching out to a Swedish soccer club subreddit to be like, hey, will you guys tell us how good your team is? And then we'll put it in the game. And apparently this is something that they have kind of been doing. If you know FIFA, if you've ever played FIFA, there are a lot of soccer clubs in this in this game. There are like a billion soccer teams. So it makes sense, all the different players. They're looking for skill moves, foot strength, pace, shooting. So you can go in to FIFA-talentscout.ea.com and volunteer your local team's stats. As far as you understand them, which is entirely subjective.
Like, anyone can just go do this?
I guess. And I think one of the things that people are a little salty about is that this is all volunteer work. They don't even pay you for doing this. EA and FIFA, one of their, like, flagship properties that brings in, like, tens if not hundreds of millions of dollars for EA, they can't even afford to do what is basic grunt work that they can at least throw $20 a team in or some sort of pittance.
Yeah.
But like to just beg people to volunteer and like that is just, it just seems scummy.
I guess your motivation is that you want your team represented? I don't know.
Yeah. No, I get it.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's it. Because I guess if you're like a local soccer fan, I would just be like, oh, my team is the best in the world. Give them all 90s. Like, all my players are 90.
They're all dope. I promise you, guys. I promise you.
I'd break it. Like, I'm surprised that 4chan hasn't found this already and started just, like, making up fantasy soccer teams.
Why not?
We should just make up teams.
Yes.
All right, guys. So if you want to go pick a random soccer club in Europe and just give them obscene stats way beyond their actual records, just visit FIFA-talentscout.ea.com and just make some shit up.
Make up a Pittsburgh team.
Oh, that'd be tight.
That's apparently where we're from.
This is Pittsburgh. How we become famous players.
Yes.
Yes.
Goalie.
Damn it.
I called it.
It's the only position name I know.
Yeah, that's really, I was like shortstop and then I went, no.
Shortstop.
Doesn't matter. You just make it up. You just add it in there. It's perfect.
Dude, we've got a goalie. We've got a shortstop. We've got a catcher, okay, and a point guard.
Dibs the point guard spot. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you a shooting guard or just straight up point guard?
I assume you're just guarding the points from happening.
Yeah. Obviously, defender.
So, I can figure this out on the fly.
Where does the quarterback tie in?
Oh, Danny.
No, it's when the guy who throws the ball in when it goes out of bounds.
Oh,
the quarterback only comes in after halftime.
Oh, okay.
Gosh.
I learned so much about sports today.
I know. We're really helpful.
At the end of each quarter? Then the quarterback comes.
Duh.
That's why it's called. I never understood. That's why it's called
quarters,
that.
Like at players.
Mm-mm. No, it's the quarter.
Common misunderstanding. Yeah. No, everyone thinks that, but no.
Okay.
Every 25 minutes. That's a quarter, right?
Do this next one. Okay. The theme. This is the theme of the sode.
Okay, so there's a story out. There's been a million stories about the coronavirus.
We're doing it.
How it's affecting coronavirus video games. Content. And we'll definitely talk that. But there's this story out this week how researchers are using a video game to fight coronavirus. Read, researchers have given up.
Just go play video games until you die.
They're like,
that's the advice we've gotten from our healthcare professionals.
We don't know. There's this game called Fold It, where it doesn't sound like a game. It sounds very boring. But you fold proteins in order to understand their structures, and you're understanding how proteins work. Well, they've added a puzzle as the coronavirus, and they like, you know, oh, we didn't give it a vaccine because we don't have one. Essentially, they're looking for somebody to just try to figure out how they can possibly fight the coronavirus using the game Fold It.
Excellent.
Guys, they have given up.
Yeah.
There is no cure incoming.
So everybody rush out and stock up on two things. Toilet paper. Because apparently everyone is planning on just shitting themselves.
I was like,
silly.
Wait, what are the symptoms of coronavirus? Is it a diarrhea virus?
That's what
Why
everyone
is everyone buying
it?
Toilet paper?
Well, and then the other thing, which you do when you have diarrhea, is drink a shit ton of water. So they've been rushing out and buying bottled water. Now, listeners, dear listeners, please.
Gotta fight the rhea.
Buddy. Explain to me why I have not found an answer to this question. Why people keep buying fucking bottled water. It is the one necessity that is literally piped into your home. And if you seriously think, oh, well, there's going to be coronavirus in the water. Motherfucker, if the coronavirus has reached the water supply and it's somehow mutated to be like non-water soluble,
now being carried through our water supply,
you were dead 3 months ago. You were fucking dead. You already died.
No. I got bottled water. We've been showering in it.
Yeah, let me tell
my teeth
you.
With
some
it.
Dudes in like a banged up VW bus pulled up to your house, came in and killed you, took all your bottled water and left 2 weeks ago, guy.
Yeah, it's gone.
But your
You're
water
dead.
In your home is still running. Because it wasn't an earthquake!
Yeah.
What is the bottled water?
But I know, I don't even. So, but I also don't understand the toilet paper thing. What is.
That one's just funny. That one's like, just funny.
What
imagine,
is
like. No, dude, that is representative of, like, America's healthcare problem. Where we're like, it's just like everyone's first thing is like, what are we gonna do? All I know is I'm gonna be shit myself silly.
I don't know, but if I can't wipe, this is gonna be a real problem going around.
Not like food or necessities. It's like the things you need for, or you'll die after a day, which is like water and apparently toilet paper.
Yeah. You could eat the paper. I don't know.
You're sitting there on the toilet just... This is a really just coming off the roll.
One,
just
one for wiping, one for eating, one for wiping, one for eating.
I'm so glad I'm a survivalist. I'm so glad I know all these things.
I am. It's amazing. I can't understand it. The other thing that killed me was my cousin went to the grocery store to do grocery shopping. All the cereal was gone except for Cheerios. And generic Cheerios.
That's the other thing, is how selective everyone is in their rationing. Apparently all the Charmin is still around because it's so expensive. I'm like, dude, you guys are seriously all thinking we're on the edge. Like, we're on the brink of a societal collapse. And you're like, I'm not going to spend an extra 60 cents on toilet paper. What am I, made out of money? Money's not going to have any value. You think Corona's going to be swimming through the fucking water.
Guys, leagues exist. Spend your money on something else.
Spend your money on bullets, because that is the world you expect we're going to be in. Bullets and shitting yourself. Fuck.
Whole thing is just
everyone's
wild.
Everyone's like looking for a reason to panic, and all the preppers here in Utah are like, this is why I go to PrepperCon every year. I'm so ready!
You just got like a garage full of toilet paper.
Do that prepper TV show, and he's like, Come check out my garage. And you think it's just going to be like guns or stuff. And he opens it literally just all the way front
to back.
Check
out my TP stash.
Toilet paper. He's like, you know what's going to happen when society collapses? You know who's going to be the king?
The great Cornholio.
The man who has all the toilet paper is king.
Oh man.
So
I don't even know.
What were we talking about?
Oh, coronavirus.
So coronavirus is shitty. Apparently way shitty. They've been canceling a lot of esports events because obviously a lot of people in esports let's just say cleanliness is not their highest priority. Looking at you, Smash community.
They have not washed their
signs
hands.
Up telling your fans to shower. I don't want to go to that on a normal a normal world where everyone
like,
is
vaccinated.
You get
a normal virus. The coronavirus is rampant.
Yeah, the Smash virus is like twice as deadly. Are you kidding me?
The Smash virus. If you ask them when was the last time they washed their hands, they will tell you in days, not minutes. I don't know. What day is it? Tuesday? I think I washed my hands last Tuesday, actually.
It was a Tuesday. I know it was a Tuesday.
Because it's hand washing day.
What year is it? Oh.
I don't know.
Well, when was my birthday?
When was the Spanish flu
outbreak?
When was
my birthday?
Also, beyond that, apparently GDC was canceled.
Sure was. Mm-hmm.
Danny, tell us about that.
Yeah.
You were going to go.
I was going to go. Not straight anymore. Up.
And it's like indie dev Christmas, right, for
it's
you guys?
It's all dev Christmas, really. So we kind of had a little bit of a heads up beforehand because it wasn't like everyone was planning on still going and then they just shut it down. Mm-hmm. Major companies started pulling out starting last week.
Yeah.
And basically, we're looking at like Sony and then Epic and Unreal pulled out, and then Unity. So those are the two major engines.
Yep.
And then a lot more studios, including like Amazon, Blizzard, Gearbox. All the announcements on Twitter were just rolling in, and there was actually a website of isgdccanceled.com.
Oh my gosh.
And it just got all of the tweets together that showed like who had just canceled. And so it basically just came down to they were going to announce on Monday, but it didn't even last that long, and they canceled like Saturday.
So what is that doing? So you, I mean, were you able to get your money back for your flight? Did you take a hit?
Hotel, flight?
Yeah,
no one has money for flight insurance.
I got hit real hard. And the thing is that the second that it was announced that they were canceling, indie devs took a major hit because like flights aren't always refundable and hotels aren't always refundable. Our Airbnb was gracious enough to give us a refund, but even then, like, it took us like 2 weeks of basically pushing and saying like, nope, we're not gonna be there.
Mm-hmm. Oh my
and
gosh.
Yeah, so there are some there's some tweets going around right now that are all about donating to a relief fund because indie teams paid a lot of money to go to this and show their game. Our team included, like we were prepping on being out in early access and getting like the world's like eyes on our game.
Yeah.
And now that's not going to happen. And we already spent all this money. So like, if you want to help out indie devs, just go on Twitter and find those Game Dev World relief funds and help them out. But the official report is that GDC is postponed until summer, but we are getting refunds on our tickets to GDC at least.
So they would have to sell tickets again.
Yes. So, there are no dates being announced or anything. They're trying to do some of our announcements online and talks and the likes. Like, they're trying.
GDC's never been canceled before either, huh?
No, not like this. Ugh. Not like this.
Well, so we've seen a lot of stories, and I think that's why we're talking about it. But we've seen so many stories about how coronavirus is affecting the industry, mm-hmm. right? The video game industry. And this is just another in the series of stories.
Yeah,
right?
I've also seen Nintendo Switch, like the production of the console itself has been slowed.
Same with
Outer
PlayStation
Worlds
and Xbox
for
right
the
away.
Switch, like that Switch cartridge. Mm-hmm. That's not coming when it was supposed to. There's been a couple. The Index that everyone's like, please give me the Valve Index, that VR headset that costs $1,000, even longer out. That's going to be, I think it's going to sell out no matter how many they make of that. Unless it's in like the hundreds of thousands, it's going to sell out immediately.
Companies are asking their teams to work from home. Right, don't come into the office, don't spread it, especially the European.
We're getting a lot of that too, even just like there are signs up in all the bathrooms now and just like down the halls, just saying like work from home even if you're sick. Like half of my team was gone today.
Yeah, that's like the majority in my office. Like everyone's just, it's a ghost town every day.
I think they're in your office, they're probably looking for a reason to work from home.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. We have a pretty robust work from home policy. Everyone's like, sweet. This is our moment. This is what we've been training for, boys.
There's even rumors right now going around that E3 may face the brunt of it.
Well, yeah, I was like, what's next, right? Yeah. If this just keeps, if the problem keeps growing, are we going to start seeing other conferences canceled and that sort of thing? I can tell you this, though. I would not go to a conference with this looming.
No.
There's just...
It's a good thing I don't work for an event management software company or anything.
Yeah.
Right? I'm good. Job security. No problem, guys. Don't worry about JD here. He's fine.
I mean, go to all the conferences.
Go to all the conferences and don't wash your hands.
Yeah. There's already the con... What do they call it? The con plague. Con plague.
Yeah.
That's our... Like, people already get sick.
It's already awful, yeah.
And adding a global virus to this is not promising. So,
all right,
coronavirus.
Yay!
Wait, why are you guys saying cheering for the coronavirus?
Working from home.
You guys will cheer for anything.
Yeah, try it. Try us.
Coronavirus.
Yay!
Yeah. Wait, what? Let's see the next story. This one killed me. Call of Duty Modern Warfare gets a knockoff Tamagotchi. If you are a child of the 90s, you will remember Tamagotchi. They were these little keychains?
Yeah, they were like a little keychain fob that had like a little virtual pet in it that you had to just meticulously take care of every waking moment until you forgot it underneath your bed for 3 years and it left.
Fish sticks?
Oh, are you hungry?
Oh, no. By all means, feed it. Play till your heart's content.
Look, Goldie. I took good care of her.
Is this the commercial?
She changed again.
Change? How about changing some water here?
Katie, boss is here.
This is the commercial in which...
Pause
a girl is neglecting her goldfish.
Her real animal.
Her real-life goldfish to play with her Tamagotchi.
Hey, kids. Hate your stupid real pet? Get a fake one.
You
want to
kill your real pet? We will teach you how.
You can kill this one as much as you want. So Call of Duty, of all things. So the COD community was really hoping to see announcements and news about the... Warzone mode, which is their battle royale mode.
Yeah.
Instead, they came out and announced that players now have the option to buy a Tamagunchi. That's what they're calling, like gun, get it?
Oh, that's very good.
Tamagunchi.
Okay.
It's a little device you can buy in the game. It's black and white. You look at it in the game and you take care of it. The way you take care of it is by doing good in matches. So killing sprees, all these things, right? The saddest part about this, why would you want this, is Tamagotchi will die if you are doing bad in the game. It gets sad and dies.
That's all I need in Call of Duty is more pressure while I suck.
Yeah, just I'm already losing and kind of pissed. Yeah. And then I look and my little guy's like, "You're killing me." And just dies right then.
Whose idea was this? Who was like, people are going to love this.
That was my question. I cannot fathom the minds that really got behind this idea and are just so excited about it. Is this the...
No, this is what happened. They had like planned features that people were like eager for, but they were so buggy and shitty. They're like, we can't launch this. Release, and they're like, what features do we have? And David,
what do you have?
Davidson down the hall has just been dicking on this thing in his free time. They're like, Davidson, we're doing the Tamagotchi thing. He's like, that was a fucking joke. That's a fucking joke. That's not real. They're like, you got 12 hours. Get it in the game. He's like, And that's what we got.
He calls up the guys who created the original Tamagotchi, and we're like, guys, listen, I got to call in a few favors. I need you.
Can I get the source code? Because there's like, no way.
I've been retired for a while now. So, I don't understand. I don't think these audiences are like... I don't think this is a cross community, but like,
I can't wait to get screamed at by a 12-year-old because I killed their Tamagotchi. Oh, like now I killed their pet.
The stakes are even higher.
Guys, please stop killing me.
Yeah.
But guys, he's gonna die.
Dude, you think those 12-year-olds are ragey now?
They're gonna be pissed.
Raise the stakes.
Yeah, you have to spend $10, right? It costs $10 to buy it.
Wait, you have to pay for this thing?
Yes.
Dude, Activision is out of fucking control. That is insane. $10 for an in-game Tamagotchi that doesn't do anything?
Yeah, you gotta
keep it. $10?
That's an Easter egg.
Oh, it will
die. That's something you just release for fun.
Yeah, like you have to unlock by doing something.
What?
Isn't that incredible?
Insane.
Wow. I don't understand. The story's hilarious, though.
$10? Okay, this next one. So we've actually got lots of game developers that are just like out of their minds this week. But the headline: Bethesda was surprised by how few people wanted to take part in PvP in Fallout 76.
Oh,
shocker! Okay, so Fallout 76 was this game that came out 2 years ago, I think. And it was essentially designed to compete in the same PvP space, kind of, as The Division and Destiny, sort of. Yeah. Basically, they just wanted to monetize Fallout in like a multiplayer or an online multiplayer model without realizing that that is
they
not
wanted
like
the
something
games as a
wants.
Service Fallout.
Yeah, they didn't want to put any of the real work into it, and then they were shocked that people weren't into it. I don't.
And they keep pumping time into this and like
this is crazy. This is a quote from Pete Hines, who is the president of some shit. You guys all know Pete Hines.
Yeah.
He's always talking about Skyrim and stuff.
Our boy.
Well, I mean, at the end of the day, our intention was always we're going to put this out there, see what folks think, and then cater the stuff that we do later to their reaction. So, for example, I think we were a little surprised how few people wanted to take part in PvP and how many more were interested in PvE together. So,
how is that surprising?
They could just look at their competitor models.
They could look at the people that play Fallout games. They're like, why do people that are invested in incredibly long single-player experiences where you spend 100 hours...
It's all about base building.
By yourself, like a sociopath in your basement. Why don't those guys want to play against each other? I just don't get it.
That's never been the Fallout model.
No.
Mm-mm.
Like, even adding other players into the game with you has never been the Fallout model.
Or something people want. You're literally... Your character's called, like, the Lone Wanderer or, like, the Soul Survivor. Yeah. Like, all these things is focusing on how alone you are and how few people there are left in this world.
Let's make it an MMO.
I know. It's so, dude. And then the other thing that offends me as someone who's obsessed with Fallout lore is that this game is set like 100 years before the current games.
It makes no sense.
It's so it's set before all the Fallout games.
Yep.
So if you guys don't remember or aren't familiar, Fallout is set in this world, this universe in which there's like a cultural stasis in the 1950s. So everything is very 1950s-esque, but it carries on well, and then the bombs don't fall until 2077. So you have all this like retro futurism, that kind of Art Deco style art style in the game, which is really cool, but it also explains how they had computers and that type of technology before the bombs fell. Well, the other games, like Fallout 1, I think picks up like 50 or 100 years after, and then like Fallout 3 is 200 years after. So Fallout 3 is 2277.
Yeah.
This game, I believe, took place like 20 or 30 years after the bombs fall. And so they're like, oh, so everything's crazy and there's all these mutants. So I watched the trailer for the new thing that they've got coming out. And dude, I was shocked. It doesn't even look like Fallout. It kind of looks like Silent Hill-esque. There's like these weird... It's the Fallout 76 Wastelanders trailer, and it's the newest expansion. And, dude, it doesn't even look like Fallout. It just doesn't feel like Fallout. And because they set it before the established, like, lore and series, it's kind of ignoring all the established canon by bringing in... Because if you put those monsters way in the future, you'd be like, oh, they developed later, whatever, right, right. Hand wave. But putting them before is like... What? Like,
yeah, it's wait,
just,
how
it's
did
just
this
a slap
happen?
In the face for anyone that likes Fallout. Yeah. So when they're like, oh, we don't understand. Like, you guys, the story itself that you chose to go with, the entire, like, world you built is not what Fallout fans want. Or it shows that they don't care about Fallout fans or understand them. So,
and I'll say this just quick about the whole headline of the story, how they were shocked people didn't like PvP. Fallout has never... The gunplay in Fallout isn't standout, right? It's not the best gunplay game out there.
It's also not really the point.
No, I wouldn't even say that. I would say it's like a 6 out of 10. Like, yeah, it is absolutely the worst part of Fallout.
And so, yeah, making that like a piece of the game where you're using that to play against other people... I don't understand how could they be surprised.
So they don't understand competitive multiplayer or PvP, and they don't understand Fallout, and they decided to combine the two.
They just took all that ignorance and just compounded on it.
It's so sad, too, because there were parts of the world that seemed so exciting, like, going in. Like, I remember seeing the first Fallout 76 trailers, being like, oh, hell yeah, Mothman.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
And
when they were kind of, like, keeping it low-key with their kind of weird one-off monsters, you'd be like, oh, I get behind this.
Keeping it, like, very West Virginia, and, like, it's in a different part of the world, right. And everything like that. That was cool. But then it just kind of, they started to come out with other decisions, like, there's not going to be any NPCs, except for robots and ghouls. Yeah. And
that doesn't make sense. Yeah. The whole point of playing Fallout is for the story.
Yeah.
It's like,
well,
it's like,
I would probably just
story.
Go back into
I don't
the
want to find my son.
Oh, no. Yeah, I'm sorry. The world and the lore, the side like stories, the story, there. All of that is above the gameplay, or the gunplay. Like,
yes.
Ugh. Anyway, now on to our favorite segment, Stadia Watch 2020.
Dude, it just gets better and better.
This is another article. I feel like Business Insider's on the Stadia beat because they interviewed a bunch of indie devs anonymously about Stadia, and this is the headline. Google's ambitious push into gaming is floundering, and it's largely due to too few... Well, that was hard to read. It's too few... games on its Stadia platform. So they're saying, you know, it's struggling because there aren't that many games on the platform. The reason there aren't that many games on the platform is because Google, essentially, this is the crux of the article, Google has done very, very, very little to incentivize developers to make games on their platform, especially indie devs.
Yeah, like, what's the appeal for an indie dev if they're not going to pay them a bunch of money to do it?
Quote from the article, this is directly from an indie developer who said that the money they were offered was so low it wasn't even part of the conversation. So it was like...
What was the conversation?
Well, dude, that's wild.
Guys,
Google rolls up with money.
Google. Come on.
Danny knows this. What kind of money do indie devs scoff at? Like $100. Like, honest to God, if someone offered an indie dev $100, they'd be like, yeah, I'll do some stuff. But it's like, they must have offered them
program
so little
on this
fucking
brand
money.
New platform. You have to do it specifically for this.
We'll buy you all lunch.
Yeah.
We'll take Blimpy, you to Chuck E. Cheese.
Blimpy or better.
Well, a big problem is that when an indie team especially is looking for where they want to publish their game or where they want to, what kind of like platforms they want to put their game out on, a huge part of it is that an indie dev team doesn't have as much marketing power as the big AAA guys. Mm-hmm. Like, not even close.
No.
Not even in the same ballpark.
Right.
And so oftentimes we have to look for other ways to incentivize those exchanges. We have to look at Oh, do they have indie feature Fridays? Oh, are they going to retweet our advertisements? Oh,
right.
Are they going to have like some sort of call out or like maybe Steam deals? Like we've seen the Epic game launcher do this so many times where you're getting more and more
games. They just throw money at it.
Yeah, they throw money at it.
They're like, here's a forkful of Fortnite cash.
Yeah.
Please come use EGS.
Yeah, please please use like our platform. And of course, like these indie dev teams are going, oh, you mean that I'm basically going to get like a front page spot on your launcher that's going to see this much like viewership over time.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but being on the front page of like Steam or one of these stores for like 12 hours,
it is gold.
All you need.
Yeah, it's gold because how these markets work is that you publish your game. And then other games are also getting published, especially on huge marketplaces like Steam.
Mm-hmm.
So the second you put your game out, it's already getting pushed back in a queue. Your downloads just, they do a dip.
Right.
Yeah.
So I feel like this, I know this is what I keep ranting about, is that Google came into this with just their typical Google arrogance and not understanding the video game industry whatsoever. Yep. I think this is another, this is more evidence for that theory that I personally believe Google doesn't know the price. They don't know what to offer indie devs because they're so green. So they come into this and they're like, they sit down at the table with some indie developers. They're like, so, you know, we're willing to give you guys $10,000. Pause for effect. And everyone's like, okay, what does that do for me?
Yeah,
that doesn't even keep the lights on for like a month. Yeah. Okay, now what? And they're like, oh, whoa, I thought they'd like that.
This is the equivalent of like an Instagrammer asking an artist for free art for exposure.
Quantify exposure.
Ooh, yeah, that just like got me.
Yeah, you get it.
Yeah,
This is the equivalent of that. No, I'm giving you exposure. Just
you don't
come
understand. So many people will see it.
Yeah. Dude, exposure to the coronavirus.
So that's one big part of it is that they don't know. What the?
I don't know. One of our listeners just posted on our Facebook page, and it just killed me. Kudos to you, Cody.
Keep on rolling, baby.
It's a scientist with a backwards cap on, looking at a vial, and it says, finally, firm biscuit. I don't know why.
We haven't brought up Fred Durst on this podcast in too long.
He's been
Thank
out of
you,
the news
Cody.
Cycle.
I think Google doesn't know what to offer indie devs financially or otherwise.
Mm-hmm.
And the other thing is, that's the other thing when you talk about exposure. EGS, for whatever flaws and faults and boycotts, is still a platform that people use.
Yes.
Stadia is not that right now, and it's certainly not a place that people who enjoy indie games are flocking to. If you're an indie developer,
because you got to double pay for it.
Yep.
Why would you, if you want to play indie games, don't go to Google Stadia.
A lot of indie games also sell for less, too, unless they're kind of like moving up into AA space. Mm-hmm. A lot of indie devs, the point is to get the game out so that you can get funding for another one.
Yep.
So that's how we end up with a lot of free-to-play indie games or like
low-price
indie games.
Free-to-play, $10. You see a lot of like 10 or under, 15 is like the sweet spot. You see that quite a bit.
And that's also because indie games are smaller. So if your gameplay experience is like 2 hours, you don't want to charge $60 for that.
Right. And so the margins are tiny. Mm-hmm. And so finances are one thing. And then the other big concern for devs is just Google's history. So I think what we're seeing here is finally Google's like infamous reputation of killing products and features that people use.
Jumping into something they have no business being in.
Killing the product and then walking away as people have lost. So I actually did a lot of digging into this. I found out there were a lot of things, you know, people have lost like work. They've lost significant things and efforts that they put in. There was a big role-playing community that was on Google Plus for a long time, and they had built out a ton of their like resources and their lore and stuff all on Google Plus, and it was spread and saved on those servers and archived. But once they got rid of Google Plus and then started to delete, like some of the stuff was saved, some of it wasn't. But Google Plus was only around for a couple years, and like they just killed it. And so that's one of their big concerns is, let's see, this is another quote: if you could see yourself getting into a long-term relationship with Google, but with Google's history, I don't even know if they're working on Stadia in a year. That wouldn't be something crazy that Google does. It's within their track record.
Yeah.
So it's like this concern that Google might just give up on Stadia at some point and kill the service, as it's done with a lot of other services during the year or throughout these years. This was brought up by every single person in the article. that they spoke to. Every single person brought up the concern that Google is just going to kill Stadia. So that's a concern coming from both sides. The developers that they need to develop games for the platform and the people that would be buying games on a platform that would go poof.
That would just disappear.
And it's a paid platform.
Yeah.
Yep. Why they shut down their free services all the time. They shut down things like Google Plus and Google Hangouts. Why would you pay for that after that record? If it was the other way around, possibly. But like the fact that they have done this so many times in the their history, they have a terrible track record. And this thing, I actually read a really long Wired article about this, is this is a cultural thing at Google. I don't know if you guys are familiar with this, but the promotion structure and like the cultural promotion structure at Google is based around new features and products. If you are supporting a legacy feature and you are doing bug fixes and patches, you are not going to get promoted. And it's not just like a maybe this or statistic that. Like, it is widely recognized that you have to do things that appeal to and raise the eyebrows of the higher-ups. And then they make sure that you're promoted up and up and up the tier because you brought out Google Stadia, for example. And you're like, this is some really cool new feature. This is lampooned on Silicon Valley, that show on HBO, quite regularly, the idea that you just roll out a feature and you're just like have no idea the space you're working in, but you just are just like think
this is something
the wild arrogance of like Silicon Valley tech bros that are like, we can just throw money at this problem and do it.
Yeah.
And this is the last quote I wanted to read that just is so amazing. It wasn't just a financial thing, one developer told me, who decided not to publish on Stadia. At the end of the day, I'm asking the question, why would I do this? And there was no positive reason to move forward.
Oh my gosh.
There wasn't really anything to want us to get in the door other than to be first on the platform. So it's like, there's no reason to do it. They've offered no incentive for gamers to get in on it. They've offered no incentive for developers, and it's this track record they have. I will post the Google product graveyard on our Discord and you guys can scroll through it. It takes like 5 minutes to scroll through. It is so long and you'll probably see products that you liked and used.
You'd be like, oh yeah, that.
And the thing is this isn't something that needs to happen. I've been using this thing. Jenna and I use it for our grocery list called Wunderlist. And it's just like a shared list that like syncs up and we can add stuff to it and delete it together. It was acquired by Microsoft like 5 years ago, and Microsoft was like, all right, we're gonna close Wunderlist, like everyone move off and migrate to this Microsoft product. We never did, never happened, and it's to this day Wunderlist is still live, active, and worked on. While they're just maintaining it, they're not adding new features, but because a ton of people use it and they realize that, and then Google just doesn't care.
Yeah.
If a ton of people are using or utilizing it or trying to like recapture that fan base or offer them something, that would help migrate them off of Google Plus or off of Google Hangouts or off these various Google products that they've killed, and they're like, no, just kill it. Completely kill it. So no, I'm not going to buy a game on that.
No.
That's my favorite. I'm so sorry.
Stadia Watch.
Stadia 2020. Watch 2020. Last fun developer story. This is just a brief one. Warcraft 3 Reforged first big event was plagued by disconnects. So this is the first big major tourney for the new Warcraft 3 remaster called Reforged. And the article is pretty bleak. One pair of people that were playing against each other disconnected 3 matches in a row.
And
the way their rules work is that they don't do a restart, because some games like Overwatch will start from like a replay point or whatever.
Yeah.
They start the whole game over again.
Oh,
and if you know how Warcraft 3 works, that is a lot. And like two of them, the guy was like, both games, the guy was like close to winning, like it was in the bag, and he had to restart and go do it. Jeez. It's such a nightmare. So it's like,
oh, that would be awful.
Oh my god, I would rage quit immediately.
I feel like this crazy. This is another Activision, just an Activision Blizzard whiff. Like, they had such an easy thing. You could have just followed the exact same path that they did with Age of Empires 2, the remakes and the remasters they did for those. But I don't know why they just felt the need to. They wanted to cut off the modding community at the knees because they didn't want another Dota 2. And then they just, I mean, they've removed maps that released with the game because they were so buggy and shitty, and they have not put them back in. So people that paid for these old Warcraft 3 maps, they took them out. They're like, oh, we'll put them back in later. And they're like, where are they?
When?
I don't know. $25 tickets. That's when we'll get to them.
Yeah.
It's kind of a common thing that's going on with a lot of Blizzard's like esports and like kind of extracurricular like tournaments right now, though, because even Overwatch League has been having some growing pains from going outside of their LA stadium. Yeah. I don't watch it much anymore, but I've got a chat that goes, and they straight up message me every time there's a DC or a tech problem, and it is not good.
Oh, yeah. Well,
dude, I don't know what they're doing. They're just pumping all their assets into the mobile games.
Yeah, that's all that matters. Diablo 4 on mobile. Kudos, I'm yours. All right, kudos is our positivity segment. After we've done a little negative dive into the news, we bring it back up.
You've been punching, taking some gut punches.
Gut punches on Stadia, yeah. Right in the kidney.
kidney shots at Google. No big deal.
Enjoy piss and blood, you fucks. my kudos this week are awful. I was driving on the freeway and I noticed a car. This is a Nissan X-Terra.
Right, you've all
I
seen
look
that.
Over and there's an X-Terra next to you. They're always driven by chicks.
This one was not driven by a chick. It was driven by your classic bro baseball cap, heavy Oakley sunglasses. And on the back of his X-Terra...
Wait, were the sunglasses on his face or on his hat?
Or on his hat backwards.
Oh, he had all three. He had three pairs of sunglasses.
Three pairs of Oakleys.
They were all everywhere.
Got
you
it.
Needed them.
Got it.
And on the back of his car, instead of saying X-Terra... It said Sex Terra.
What?
In very clearly outlined decals that looked, they matched perfectly. And I was just
so they add an SE, right?
I was like, you do look like,
just the
you
S.
look like the kind of guy.
No, because it's X, the letter X, Terra.
So they put SE before X Terra.
I'm going to find this man and beat him.
I know. I was like, dude, kudos to you for being that guy. So the best part of the story is that I put this on the dock just like to remember, to remind myself.
Thought it was funny.
And Peterson sees it and he Googles it and he's like, dude, that Sex Terra thing's funny. I was like, wait, what did you Google? So I Google it. Come to find out, there is a community online of Sex Terra fans. People that are discussing different decals, different fonts.
What's the font for the X? Because I want mine to match.
Dude.
I want my car to say Sex Terra, but I don't want it to look weird.
I want it to look like that was like from the factory. Dude, it's
hilariously love you, stupid. Guy. Kudos to you. You just wear that sleeve.
Bro, you got to buy an X-Terra just so you can do this. Like, is there somebody out there who thought this was so awesome that they actually went and bought an X-Terra just so they could do this?
Oh, you know
there's
got to
be.
There's someone out there.
There's probably like a ton of them.
Yeah.
No, this is not an idea you come up with after you've owned the car for a while.
No.
You started calling it Sex Terra at the dealership, and the salesman was like, ugh, another one. Like,
honey, okay. We need to buy a new car. What kind of car do you want? Oh, you know, I've been thinking about getting an X-Terra. An X-Terra, why?
Don't ask.
Don't worry about it. You'll love it.
Everyone will think it's so cool. All your girlfriends will like it. Trust me.
Oh, babe, you're gonna love it.
Oh, babe.
Yeah. Oh, Sex Terra guy calls all women babe.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Every single one of them.
Hey, babe. Ugh.
Danny, you said you had some kudos.
Yeah. Mine's kind of a kudos in advance because I have a friend who's actually been my best friend for about 10 years. And I know he listens to all these episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And he has a huge hacking test. This
Ooh,
weekend, yeah.
Tight.
This dude is basically, his name is Xander, and this dude basically saw Mr. Robot and said, oh, I'm going to do that. And then
That's
he
what I
did.
Want.
He just did it because he's just that smart, and it still blows my mind that he just like saw this thing and just did it. But he has this, he compares it to me, who is not a hacker and does not know the computer words despite working in games. He described it as the law, like bar exam of hacking.
Oh.
So he's got like a.
Hack the planet!
Shut up and get in the car!
Hack the planet!
Hack the planet. Sorry.
Yeah,
to
no, that's basically Xander. And he's both of them somehow.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, he's got like this huge test. So I want to wish him luck and give him a kudos that, like, you know. He got this.
So is this like he's trying to work in info security or like pen testing or something? Like he already does this?
Yeah, he already does this, but so he's badass. He's also a composer for games. So he's
Does he go to DEF CON?
I don't know if he's actually been to DEF CON or not, probably.
Yeah, he probably has. I've heard some stories that DEF CON just sounds like the coolest shit.
We've met Xander, good guy.
Yeah.
We met him at Salt Lake Gaming Con.
Oh, yeah.
We did a panel with him.
Yeah.
No, good guy. So hope you nail it, Xander.
Mm-hmm.
Kill it.
Kudos for living my dream, because Hackers has been one of my favorite movies since I was like 12.
Okay. But one of my favorite things about Hackers in movies is that they are gods. They hack into something and they can do anything.
Have you guys seen Hacker Typer?
Yeah. So Xander has shown me Instagram stories of like his screen when he's doing hacking, and it looks like that. It looks like fucking Matrix is just happening on his screen. He's just like, haha, Tuesdays. I'm like, what
are you doing?
I don't even know.
My brain doesn't even work that fast. No. It takes me 30 minutes to type a one paragraph email to my boss, because I'm like, okay, what do I want to say?
Well, that's because your fingers
am I going to say this? And then I fall asleep a couple times. my fat fingers hit all the keys at once. All right, well, kudos, Xander. I hope you nail it. Best of luck.
Don't you have one, Peterson?
Oh, so I have a kudos. Gosh, this show, I just randomly picked up. I don't know why I hadn't heard about it. It's called Narcos. And I actually didn't realize, I will say, I didn't realize that there's two different shows. They're in they're, you know, like spinoff shows. Mm-hmm. So it started off, there was a show called Narcos. I started watching Narcos Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm watching Narcos Mexico, and it's about in the 80s how, you know, marijuana was being made in the in Mexico. And they were, you know, shipping it up through the U.S., but it wasn't organized. Well, a guy comes in and organizes it and makes the first Mexican cartel. That's what the story is, and it's based off a true story. So, like, sometimes when a big event will happen...
Cartels were so much cooler in the 80s. You could, like, instead of just, like, mutilating and just torturing people, you just got more organized.
Well, that's what he did. He, like, organized all these people. Like, there was some killing. But, yeah, he was, like, a business guy, right? He's a business guy. He wasn't, like, a...
What business does
light
pass?
Light killing.
Light killing.
Yeah, just like a pinch.
Guys... Any successful company will tell you.
80% accounting, 10% process, 5% organization.
Just a pinch of killing.
As a treat.
Yeah. Ask any Nestle executive. Come on.
It's like one of those things you just have to get your hands dirty, right? You got to do it.
A little bit.
It's going to happen. So anyways, it's about that, though, when they make this first cartel in Mexico growing and shipping marijuana. So, I mean, the content is bleak, right? But then it's about the DEA agents. And this is when the DEA had just started as an agency. So they don't have any funding or backing, and no one cares about them. And they're kind of a joke. And so you're following this DEA agent, and you're also following simultaneously the cartel leader,
mm-hmm.
right? And so it's this story, and I am so hooked. It is incredibly well done. Michael Pena is the DEA agent. All the acting in it is incredible. There's lots of reading because it's in Spanish, right?
Yeah.
Most of the dialogue's in Spanish.
That's nice.
Even the DEA agents, who most of them are white,
right?
They're speaking in Spanish, right? Because they're in Mexico, so it's all. But guys, it is riveting. It's so well done. It's well written. They do a little bit of that documentary thing. So like when something big happens. That happened in real life,
mm-hmm.
they'll actually like show news stories. Ooh. And there's like a voice over guy will be like, and so this happened, and they'll show pictures and stuff. Oh God, it's so good, you guys. So watch, I texted my brother and he said, have you watched all of it? Have you watched regular Narcos, mm-hmm. which is about Colombian cocaine cartels?
Oh yeah.
And he's like, watch all of it. It's all incredible. It's so good. So If you're into that sort of like, you know, riveting, you know, it's kind of a drama thriller type of TV show, check out Narcos. You can start on either. So you should start timeline wise on Narcos and then go into Narcos Mexico. I did it backwards. It hasn't affected me at all. I'm obsessed with it. It's so good.
Speaking of like Colombian cartels, that just brought back.
Well, okay, where's this going?
tight.
So I have a job interview later this week.
So did you guys ever do like the Model UN stuff in high school?
No.
Oh, no?
I wish.
I'd never heard about it until I was like in my mid-20s.
I just thought of it again because we didn't really have Model UN either in my high school, but our government teacher did something very different that was essentially a giant, like, class-wide, like, 60-student game of Risk.
Tight.
But there weren't enough countries to really, like, pair up students to do that. So your girl played the Colombian drug cartel.
Shut up.
It was awesome.
Freaking Escobar over here.
Oh, I straight up took over Venezuela and Colombia. It was amazing. And I just, like...
She's like, well... Yeah. Technically, none of the rules apply to me, so I can do whatever I want.
I straight up could do, because I got to, like, sit in the dark corner of the classroom with Al-Qaeda, and we just, like, ruined other people's grades.
Wait, can we kill that guy?
This doesn't even sound like Model UN. It just sounds like role play.
Yeah,
wait. Sound remotely like Model UN.
Guys, we don't have it. We can just kill these guys over here. You see these delegates over here?
We can just, like, take over China if we want to.
I'm pretty sure we can take them out.
We just, like, bribed people outside of class and did all sorts of things. Like,
The teacher looks away for a minute, looks back. Danny and the Al-Qaeda delegates have a couple ambassadors tied up in the corner. They're like, what are we doing? They're like,
we want a plane.
I don't know what happened.
We want $2 million in unmarked cash and 6 guns.
That's not how this works.
Dude, well, Model UN of Danny was a trip.
You're never seeing Peru again, I can tell you that.
No.
Get out of here.
Wait, where's Peru? Has anyone seen the delegate from Peru?
We won't see Peru for a while.
Guys, don't worry about Peru.
Start digging.
Argentina's next.
All right, so let's get into the meat of the show. Let's see how this works.
Ham.
Ham's a meat, so we're going with
ham.
Ham. Ham.
I didn't know ham had two syllables.
It does. It does.
Ham.
Oh, yeah. Who? That lady.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
That one's
for Spencer. Let's get into the ham of the episode. And we're doing coronavirus content because you know I love it.
We're back, baby. Wash your hands.
Ah, no, I'm not washing my hands.
Wash
and I'm
going
to keep touching my face.
Look, if I have to have the coronavirus, you guys have to hear about
it. Everyone gets to have it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't wait until the real episode we can't record because we all have it. So our first segment we wanted, Peterson, you tell us.
Oh, so, okay, guys, we're doing a little role play here. We're just doing a little scenario. We're not role playing. We're just doing a scenario. Here's the question. Obviously, there's a business idea here, right? My MBA brain started turning.
Yeah.
How can we profit off of this coronavirus?
Oh, of course.
Right?
Besides toilet paper.
Well, that one's already taken. Friggin' Charmin. Charmin has the TP game on lock. I tried to get in. There's no way.
I was just gonna say, I'm wiping with paper towels.
I gotta go get my DI bag out of the garage and use that.
The DI bag. I just am still picturing you trying to flush it, though.
Flush a t-shirt.
Stuffing it down the sock, trying to get it down the toilet.
Old pair of jeans.
This is why they were hoarding toilet paper. I finally understand.
You just leave the bathroom window open. And
you
just
can't
toss it
flush
out.
Jeans. I should have known.
Oh my gosh, push the... Never mind. Okay, so we're gonna profit off of these pandemics that are happening, all these crazy things that are happening in the world. So we're gonna start a company that makes emergency shelters specifically for gamers, though. Mm-hmm. 'Cause we gotta stick with what you know. So first off, we're starting a company specifically for gamers. We need a name of the company. We need our base package. We need our primo package. So what is it? What is it called?
Okay, I feel like the company has to be called Vault Tech.
But I feel like it has to be sponsored by someone like Cheez-Its or Doritos or like just or some company.
Mountain Dew sponsored Vault Tech.
Yeah. Or the different vaults or just like the Mountain Dew pitch black.
Vault Tech, we don't want to get sued because we're a brand new company. Can it be like Vault Tank?
Vault Tank.
Vault Tank.
No, just Vault Tech. Just put a C in it because there's normally
Vault
just
Tex.
A K.
Just make it an
Vault
X.
Vault Tech.
Vault Tech.
Oh, yes. The asylum method.
Oh,
Transmorphers.
Guys, I wasn't thinking asylum. I apologize.
Now
I should always be there. Okay, no, I like that. I was trying to think of a good one, but Vault Tech is pretty good.
Because in the Fallout universe, Vault Tech is this evil corporation that, mm-hmm. before the bombs fell, that they were building Fallout. They were building Fallout shelters, mm-hmm. but just as human experiments. To
They were not trying to save people.
No, and that was never the intention.
I just think of the branding that we would have to do for this, because we have to get like those gamer like lines in, like you see on like a nice desktop computer. Got to get some LEDs. Got to get a little RGB in there.
Whoa! You're talking about the Primo.
Yeah, I was
going to
say that does sound like the Primo package, though.
We got our basic. I called it the Mad Cats package.
Oh,
it's not the good package. It's the
one
discount you don't want.
Package that your friend hands you when you show up at his house, and you're like, oh.
"This is like the this is the extra." So, what does the Mad Cats package look like?
Okay, so
an office chair you've had for the last decade.
It's like a wooden chair, no padding on it.
No padding, and like it's kind of off center enough that like you have a wheel that's like taped back on.
Oh god!
So every
a wheeled chair, and the wheels, if you pick it up, two of the wheels will fall off.
Yeah, you got to tape them on.
You just leave them on there.
They don't really roll anymore.
I
might just
the
be
ball
describing
bearings
my chair.
Just kind of spill. I was just gonna say, I feel attacked when you said 10-year-old office chair. I was like, is 10 years old for those? Oh man.
Look, I know I need to replace it, all right?
God, Danny, yes, seriously. So in my neighborhood, every single house was built in 1955 on the same footprint and the same like property line kind of thing. And one of my neighbors recently dug up his house and rebuilt it and discovered, and everyone in the neighborhood was really delighted to learn, we all have septic tanks in our backyard. Decommissioned septic tank. So I go online. I'm like, what do you do with a decommissioned septic tank? They're like, well, here's what you do. You can hire a company to come out and fill it with sand or cement, or just sit and wait for 70 years till it collapses and there's a giant poopy sinkhole in the back of your yard. So guess which one I'm going with?
Sand?
No. That sounds so expensive. No. What's going to happen
is just dig it up and fill it with sand.
In 20 years, that sounds like a lot of sand. In 20 years, I can just cut a rough hole in it, throw a couple extension cords down there. They're running from the house. Cover the extension cords in carpet.
The septic tank package.
Yeah, dude, it's there for me. Guess what? So like in the fancy, you know, shelters you see, they've got these like hydroponics that are growing the plants. You got the septic tank package. You don't need that, brother. Because guess what? Them mushrooms growing on the side, those are free. You can just eat those. You got a mushroom farm everywhere around you. No hydroponics necessary.
Living in a compost pit, basically.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It's decommissioned, Danny. It's fine.
I don't know. Mine was more of a shelter, but listen. It's the Mad Cats package. So it's not going to be great. It's one room. Okay, it's down, obviously down below, down underground. Mm-hmm. One room, there's one table, two chairs. That's it. Not nice chairs. Like those wooden chairs.
The
like
office
Danny.
Chairs, yeah.
Just real awful. there's one bed, but it's like a prison. You know, like when you watch like Shawshank Redemption.
Like a cot?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. It's just like that. It's not nice. But okay, we are a gaming company, so we got to throw in some game stuff. Couple decks of cards.
Mm-hmm.
You get two decks of cards.
Okay.
But
what are they missing?
They're both missing a card, and they're not the same size,
mm-hmm.
and so you can't really shuffle them together very well.
You
can't use that
one card from the other one. You'll know. Yeah.
Yeah. No. There's no replacing. The other thing is, you know, you're gonna need to kill a lot of time when there's an apocalypse happening. So puzzles are a great way to do that. We'll include three puzzles. However, it's all the same picture, but the cuts are all different, and they're each missing pieces.
Oh hey, that's God. What I have.
So we're doing this because we don't want them to order the Mad Cats package.
See, I just thought you were going to say, like, give them an Amazon Basics Xbox controller, and that would be, like, the deal breaker.
Wait, what is in there?
Yeah, meanwhile, I'm picturing a very rough cut hole in a septic tank that you're cramming all of these things through. You get an old couch, and you have to, like, stomp on it to get it through there.
Some couch cushions.
Whatever you can shove through the hole is what you got. You drag the extension cord from your house, tuck it down the fucking hole. Everything goes in the hole, including you. That's
you
your
get down
new
there
house.
And you're like, hi, why are there jeans down here?
I found an old pair of jeans down there.
This is perfect. I'm going to be pooping like a king.
I don't even need toilet paper.
Yeah, if you live in a septic tank, the bathroom is everywhere. Do you need a bathroom? No.
You idiots are buying toilet paper. We're over here in the septic tank itself.
It takes care of my poops.
Yeah.
No matter where they are.
Wasting cash.
Okay, so the Primo package.
Right.
obviously has a fully functioning door, like Fallout, like a Fallout vault door.
Yeah. It has electricity.
Oh, yeah.
It has electricity.
A deep freezer full of Hot Pockets and pizza rolls, because those are going to last forever, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, even if the freezer goes out,
they're fine.
Guys, probably. It's fine.
But it's not going to go out because you have a power-generating stationary bike. So there's absolutely...
Oh, nice.
So, like, the power goes down or your solar panels are down, you're not going to...
Yeah, you need another
file.
Way.
You're gonna keep. Yeah, you're gonna just sit on your bike.
So I included a bunch of. So there's obviously game systems in there, right? Danny's here, which made me think there's a lot of D&D. There's a wall of D&D stuff because if you've got multiple people in there, how much time can you spend just doing D&D?
That could be so dangerous though, because you're gonna get someone who's gonna play a murder hobo, and then the whole party dynamic is gonna go to shit.
It's fine. It's,
but then you can kill and eat them.
You can play a murder hobo session.
Yeah.
And then you can play.
Move on.
Yeah,
just play. You've got lots of time to kill down there. Board games, like a wall of board games with replay value, like Dominion, right? With all the expansions. Long games like Gloomhaven. But the big thing that makes this primo is there's an anti-raider room. Obviously, there's raiders in this situation, right?
Yeah.
Have you ever played a game... in apocalyptic situation where there weren't raiders?
No.
Like, my first instinct if there was an apocalypse is to be a raider.
Yeah, you're right. Like, well,
I'm a toilet paper hoarder now.
Join up with some other people.
Steal everyone's toilet paper.
Yeah.
You think it's going to be like booze or bullets? It's not, guys. It's toilet paper.
Toilet paper and like meth and Sudafed. It's like medicine.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, that's what I'm doing. I'm just going to hoard all the medicine and then everyone has to come to me.
I'm just
all the diuretics.
Like, I'm just over here, like, getting, like, license plate and, like, making armor out of them. And, like, I'm already on that, like, level where Danny's, I'm, like, making nail.
Four people have died, and Danny's over here making armor out of license plates.
This is what we're doing.
Like, Danny, electricity's still on.
What are you doing?
For now, but look at my spikes.
She's like, nope, gotta go out into the wasteland. Ah! She got, like, her little hobo pack, and she's, like, wandering out into the middle of the desert.
Yeah.
What are you doing, Danny? Just
snapping pieces off of cars.
Things are still good.
That is somebody's vehicle. Someone was driving that earlier. I needed this for
is
my
this
weapons.
Like a cosplay situation? No, guys, Mad Max. Think Mad Max.
The other thing you have to have if you have the primo package, right, and you're super secure, you've got your Raider room, is a streaming setup. So you can tease everyone. That's still out there.
You can just show them.
Hey guys, thanks for checking in on the stream. Here, day 120.
Still alive down here.
Still alive, not sick. You know, I feel real good.
Doing great.
Still have a pile of jeans.
My KD ratio is just like so good.
Yeah. Wait, did you finish telling us about the Raider room?
Oh no,
what is the Raider room?
So the Raider room, right? Obviously, there's raiders, so they're gonna come in. So it's just like a panic room.
No.
In this, but they're gonna come take over your shelter, right? Mm-hmm. So you have, you know, it has its own electricity, own ventilation, because they're gonna try to come in and like take over your stuff. And
two bad guys, all the TPs in here in my Raider room.
You guys are gonna die. You can't wipe that butt. so you can shut down the door, the main door to the shelter. And there's just a couple of poison grenades or something.
Mm-hmm. That's where the actual out there. Septic tank is.
Yeah. Toss them out there. You kill them. It's essentially your room where you wait out the raiders. You let them die. Mm. And you take them out. And then you come back out and you start streaming, I guess, again.
Yeah. You're just like, anyway.
Guys,
sorry guys.
I'm back.
Day 250. Saw some raiders came. Totally took over my shelter. Broke my arm.
They're dead now, though. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Cooking those guys up.
Okay, so this next one.
What's the scenario?
The scenario. Let me paint the scene for you. We're all doing role-playing. That's the whole week. All right, so you fake your way into one of these shelters, right? There's people inside telling you to stay out and manage just somehow.
You convince them to let you in.
Con them in. Even though you know you have this virus that turns you into a crazy rage monster.
It's a rage virus.
It's
like
a rage
that.
Virus, okay. Yeah.
And you know you have it.
You know you have
but
it.
But you want in.
Well, yeah, because I want to be comfy, and maybe they have a cure in there. I don't know.
Yeah, we don't know what they have.
Dude, there is no altruism in any of these movies.
They got Hot Pockets. I want them.
Yeah.
I'm not going to die without a Hot Pocket in my hand.
I'm not going to eat rats, okay?
Yeah,
There's
no.
Hot Pockets.
I need in that shelter.
On the other side of the
store. I'm a human being. Let me in. So
makes sense.
But you know, eventually these signs of your virus are going to start manifesting. Mm-hmm. So you got to get everyone else in the shelter a little antsy, a little angry. Because if everyone else is angry and raging, they'll never notice you.
They won't point the finger at you.
And you can just eat your Hot Pockets in peace.
In fact, you can point the finger at other people.
And be like, that guy has the virus.
Get kicked out.
Hey, we have any more Hot Pockets?
Extra HPs, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly. Yeah. Like the more people that are kicked out. Yeah, so you have the rage virus. You've gotten in. What games do you pick? What games did you knock on the shelter door with?
So you show up. Okay, you're the idiot. Only thing you grabbed
was
in the apocalypse.
Video games.
You've got those huge board game backpacks, you know?
Oh, yeah.
They're like really big. That's all you have. And it is full of board games and video games.
Yeah.
What do you bring?
What do you have
what do
in
you play?
There? Yeah.
Mary Poppins bag.
I got to go with Overcooked.
Oh.
And I am not giving you any instructions on how to play it.
Perfect.
You need to play it with them and just kind of suck just enough to where they're getting pissed.
Right.
And you'd be like, no, okay, why don't you direct now? You know what? I'm not doing very good at this. Why don't you tell me what to do?
Mm-hmm.
Right? And they're going to get pissed.
Yeah.
Oh, smart.
Yeah,
Overcooked.
I was also thinking
they're effed.
Simple. Mm-hmm. Everyone will be able to get in it. Checkers, but you just remove one piece. So
one
it guarantees
gun.
There's going to be shit talking literally no matter who wins. Because if you are playing with one piece less and you win, you're going to shit talk. So you're like, I beat you and I didn't even have you had more pieces than me. If you lose because of it, I just lost because you had more pieces. It just doesn't matter. There's always going to be shit talking.
Oh,
and everyone's going to be frustrated in checkers because they just can't.
You bring extra pieces of theirs, right? And sneak them onto the board, then accuse them of cheating.
Yeah.
Oh,
there's a lot of devious stuff you could do with board games. I was thinking Monopoly.
Yeah.
Just
like,
play the bank wrong.
I feel like most of the arguing actually comes from disagreeing over what the rules are. So you just don't have the rules with it.
God.
So it just turns into being like, well, it did say that.
A whole box of games, including Monopoly. Especially Monopoly.
Yeah, yeah.
Monopoly without the rule book to yell at. And everyone's Monopoly game, the rule book is slightly ripped from one person grabbing it from someone else at one point.
I feel like you need to be a little bit subtle here. Mm-hmm. Here's how you do it. You pull out a game that one of the other people knows how to play, have them explain the rules, and then you purposefully ignore those rules. Oh. I can tell you, any board game player, if they have said a rule two or three times, because I know I do this, I'm like, guys, you have to pay attention. Someone's going to mess it up. This is the rule in this situation.
They mess it
mess
up anyway.
That up?
Yes.
Oh, they, and then you have to accuse them of never telling you. Dude, you never said it. I was paying attention. You never said this. How am I supposed to know that's a rule? They'll get so pissed off. Trust me.
This is straight up gaslighting. You're just describing gaslighting.
Yes.
That's amazing.
Yep. No.
Incredible.
Mario Party is an obvious
Mario
one.
Party, yeah.
Mario Party on the 64, though. Ooh. Those are the ones where they issued gloves like later because people had been – there was one thing where you do this with your palm.
Blistering
people, had blistered their hands. My brother got one, I remember, when that game was out. He came home
with
this giant round blister because you would do the –
rubbing your palm on that one to move it. I was going to say even simple, charades or Pictionary.
Oh, yeah.
But you have to be the weak link. That's the thing. You're trying to manipulate these people into getting angry. You just need to suck. You need to suck at guessing. You need to suck at actually doing it. Like, your drawing needs to be so bad. Or, like, misreading the cards on accident, you know, and drawing something different. Here's one that pissed off my family. Ticket to Ride. Because I had played so much of the regular version of Ticket to Ride that I had memorized all of the routes just by playing so much.
Mm.
And so they would put down, play two routes.
Yeah.
I already knew what they were doing. And I would block them. And they got so pissed to where they were like, we're never playing this game
again. Yeah, I was
going to
say, just play Ticket to Ride. Don't try to win. Blocks only.
Just block.
Blocks only.
Blocks only. Dark Souls, obviously. Just put on Dark Souls. Have somebody play it.
By themselves.
They'll get kicked out
in
30
say,
minutes. They will be gone.
You guys go to the living room and checked on Jerry? You should go check on him.
Check on Jerry.
I think he has the rage.
I don't know. I don't know exactly the symptoms of the rage virus. I don't know what that is.
Oh, you could get.
But like, you should go check on Jerry. Just I don't know what the symptoms are.
I don't know. He may or may not be super ragey. It's like FIFA. Isn't that the one that's like a controller killer? Because everyone throws their controllers at the floor when they're playing FIFA. Like, all you need to do is get a game when someone's going to slam a controller, and then you're like, go check on Jerry. Go check on Jerry.
Get a competitive game like that and be like, I've never played this before. And just like, whoop them.
Wow. You,
what is happening?
It's so easy. Don't you think it's easy?
Dark Souls is pretty easy. You guys are going to love this. I just breeze right through it, but it's so fun.
Danny, do you have any rage inducing? Mm. I kind of like removing all the instruction manuals from all the games. That's
that's kind of what I think of immediately, because that's immediately how I get my family upset with any games, because I found out something about like my family just over the course of bringing board games and video games to every Christmas, because mm-hmm. it's just something that we would do when mm-hmm. we'd get together. What we'd always do is just we would pick a game that only maybe two people played,
mm-hmm.
and we would introduce everyone else to the game. Oftentimes they were puzzle games.
Right.
I have family that they are like, everyone's got like an education. I've got like doctors and lawyers and all sorts of stuff in my family. I give them puzzle games that are the most janky shit you can find. That it's not even your fault for not figuring it out at right. this point. It's just like the piece is not clicking or something is wrong. And I just leave them with it. I just leave them with it. And sure enough, like Surgeon Simulator actually gets a little bit of that. My sister, she is a gastric like surgeon. Mm-hmm. And she's sitting there and they're like giving her a C mm-hmm. on her surgery job. And she's like, no, no. No! Like, she gets so pissed.
I love that.
So I just think of doing something like that. It gaslights you. Yeah. Again, it's the gaslighting thing.
Categories. Oh. Just vote people down every single time. Nope. That doesn't sound right. I have never heard of that. No, everyone vote. Thumbs down.
The last one I thought of was the co-op game I played with Jenna a couple years ago. The one that was made by Double Fine and Ron Gilbert. The Cave.
Yep, I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah.
Because there is a functionality, and it's deliberate. This is how they designed it, is if one person leaves the screen, whoever leaves, like, so it's a side-scrolling game, and if, like, Peterson's standing in the middle of the screen, and I walk off to the right, it'll follow me to the right, and then it'll keep going, and then Peterson will lose control of his character. And it's, it is really, really obnoxious. It is antithetical to like most co-op games, but that was deliberate because they're like, we want you to, that open different gameplay things.
Yeah.
But what it does is it leaves you sometimes, you're off to the left working on something, like trying to land a jump or do something, and someone just wanders off to explore to the right, and you just lose your guy, you might fall, you have no idea where you went. It is so irritating, and if you did that, I mean, we were driving each other nuts, and Jenna and
you were trying
very
to play
cooperative.
Well together.
Yeah, I can't even fathom how
you could easily troll somebody.
Like, oh, sorry, I was just going over here really quick, and then like wait and watch what they're doing. You're like, okay, I'll let you go, because you have to agree to be like, I'm gonna go to the left and take the screen, like you have to stay over here. Sometimes you're standing on a pad and they have to go to like the left and you have to keep standing on that pad, but you lose control of your character if you are off screen. It's not like you can just walk to the right a little bit and be back on screen. It's like you're gone. I think that would drive people absolutely insane.
Can't even fly back in like Tails.
Nope. There's no way back.
There's no Tails back in.
Yeah.
Helicopter.
Yeah. After he's died the 30th time.
Yep.
All right, guys. Next up, we have our second radio play. Why don't we just do it?
In the near future, a deadly virus has decimated 90% of the population. Those who have survived the illness have been holed up in bunkers, waiting for the virus and the panic to subside. Our tale begins in one of these bunkers, where we find three survivors, JD, Peterson, and Danny, that have been cooped up for nearly a week.
Oh, hey guys, I'm just gonna head outside real quick.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I'm just going to get some fresh air outside. No biggie.
Dude, there's a pandemic going on outside.
Dude, it's not that big of a deal. It's just like a cold that you get. Everyone is super overreacting.
I mean, I don't know, man. It kills like 90% of people.
Exactly,
who get it.
90%.
Dude, what is going on with you?
Oh, Peterson, not again.
What?
Tell him.
Look, it's Pokemon Go. Okay, I need to play it.
Virus!
Dude, somebody just took over my gym.
I don't care if someone took... Wait, what?
Yeah, who the hell took over your gym? Who the hell is that?
It's probably Joey. He's a kid in my neighborhood.
I'm sorry, who?
It's Joey. We trade together. Team Valor, you know?
exactly how old is Joey Peterson?
You know, I don't really know. I think he's like 9.
Peterson, that is not a 9-year-old out there.
Okay, he could be like 11 or 12. We've actually never met IRL.
So you're going outside then?
Yep, going outside.
To play Pokemon Go.
Got it.
With Joey.
100%. We gotta take back the gym from those stupid Team Mystic nerds.
Hey, you punks want to see a dead body?
I'm sorry, what?
Oh, I'm just funking on you. Let's go get that gym. Mystic Bastards.
Ooh, Mystic Bastards, band name.
So, Joey, how long would you say you've been out here just wandering around?
I don't know. A day, a week. Hard to tell when you smoke this much gack, am I right?
Gack?
Yeah, follow me. It's just right over this hill.
Hey, JD, I'm not liking the sound of that cough Joey's got.
Oh, I'm pretty sure that's just the gack.
It is gack. No one will tell me what gack is.
I don't know. It's something that makes you cough.
Yeah, I'm gonna say something. So, Joey, been hanging out with any, sick people lately?
Sick people? Yeah, me? All the time.
What the fuck?
Look, sneezing people, and coughing people, and oozing people. You know, people with those bones that come out of your skin?
Oh, yeah, that sounds great. Peterson, you need to take care of this.
Yeah, I know. Hey, Joey, come on, I gotta show you something over in these trees over here.
It's for the best. Probably.
Probably. Yeah. Gonna really miss Joey, though.
Really?
No. Super gross, and he definitely has the virus.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Hey, Peterson. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great. I got 2 phones now. Twice the Pokemon Go action. And Joey left me some gack, so that was really nice, too. Now let's go hit that gym. It's just over that hill.
Dude, I think we got it. That was awesome. That was really good.
It was really good.
You didn't even break.
Oh, man.
It was dying. I almost broke. Yeah. When I was like, he's going to do the Joey. He's going to do the Joey.
Like, don't make eye contact.
Oh, yeah, I did.
I know, I was like, I cannot look at anybody throughout this whole thing.
I can't watch the video of it, because I think we're both going to be like...
We're all like this.
Mm-mm. I just fucking covered my mouth.
Yeah, me too. I was like, mm-mm.
Don't you play no reindeer-gasmic supernova with me.
All right, guys. Reindeer-gasmic supernova is our game... Our little game segment where we play mini games on the SODE, and this week's game is Shelter, Loot, Kill.
So this is our playoff of Crew Carry Kill.
Which is our playoff of
what's it called for real? Screw Mary Kill.
Yeah.
We did Crew Carry Kill. Now we're doing Shelter, Loot, Kill. Which I assume means you let them into the shelter.
Mm-hmm.
This is someone banging. There's a lot. We just stuck with this trope and just leaned right into it. Someone banging on a shelter, let me in.
Well,
that was
I
the
assume
only thing
by
we
the
got.
Time this episode airs.
You're listening to it in your shelter.
Yeah, you're in the shelter because most of the people you know are dead. This is not going to be a high listen to episode. The numbers are not going to be great. I already know.
They just said, told the same joke for 2 hours. It was really weird.
And half of our listeners didn't make it.
So you are going to... This person is banging. There are 3 people. They're banging on the door. And you get to choose to let one into the shelter. One, you're just going to steal all their shit and leave them standing naked,
yes,
like the road. And then the other one, you just kill them. Because, I don't know, they offended you.
Because you just don't like them.
And you
like
have
them,
that power.
I guess you can loot them, too, once they're dead.
Yeah.
Technically. But that's not the That's not the theory behind kill, right?
You also kind of have to think of it like you can loot someone and like they can't do anything about it. They won't come back and get you later.
Yeah. No, definitely.
Okay, so just game characters. All I got is game characters for you.
All right.
Okay.
All right. The first crew that shows up is Sonic, Mario, and Donkey Kong. Starting easy.
Okay. Oh, you think this is easy? I have to kill a beloved character?
Ooh, I have an even tougher one, but yes, go on.
Oh, great. Okay, so let's see. Danny, who do we let into the shelter?
Oh, I know who I kill.
Oh.
I'm going to kill Donkey Kong, because that's meat.
Yeah.
Oh, true.
He's not going to have anything on him.
Yeah.
And I don't want a giant fucking monkey in my shelter.
No, he was definitely not a shelter. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Hedgehogs don't have a lot of meat.
No, kill that giant monkey.
His little legs are so scrawny. we're going to eat Donkey Kong. This is bleak.
It's going to
start.
Guys,
the situation is bleak.
Gone
okay?
downhill.
Yeah.
But we are going to eat Donkey Kong. We're going to kill him for his meat.
Yeah.
For his sweet gorilla meat.
For that sweet gorilla meat?
Can you even eat gorilla meat?
We'll find out.
We will find
out. Look up some gorilla recipes.
Okay.
Okay. And then let's see.
Endangered.
Oh,
I know. I'm going to let Sonic into my shelter.
Okay.
Here's the thing, because he would be great at scavenging.
Yeah.
That's kind of what I was thinking, too.
Just send him out there. Be like, hey, Sonic,
like,
we need
a literal runner.
Go get us some
what if the plumbing goes down in your shelter? Wouldn't it be nice to have a plumber there?
What if all those sleeves you cut off are getting caught up in the tubes and the pipes?
Guys, just telling you, don't Google gorilla meat. Just don't do it. It will make you very sad. I hate it. I fucking hate it.
So is it edible?
I don't know. It's very sad, though. They all look very sad to me.
Well, I mean, I guess we've all been desensitized at this point.
Yeah.
So we're not so sad about Donkey Kong's situation.
Like if Sonic breaks his leg, he's next on the chopping block.
That's
like,
true.
Yeah, you know. But I'm never going to eat Mario. I'll just tell you that right now. Never going to eat Mario.
I will beat up Mario. Happily.
Loot Mario, he probably has some food on him, some mushrooms.
Oh, yeah.
He's got some coins. I don't know what we'll do with the coins, but Mario's got some stuff on him.
Yeah, and like, what's he going to do, jump on me?
So, maybe he has one of those fire mushrooms.
Oh.
We can throw fireballs for a little bit.
Yeah,
I don't want him to use them.
No,
I want to use them.
Yeah.
Screw you, Mario.
Enjoy
You're so
not having
selfish.
Any stuff.
You keeping all your giant mushrooms and your fire mushrooms? I want it. I'm taking it.
Yeah. Have fun sleeping outside with Donkey Kong's head.
Just beat up Mario. Take all his stuff, throw him out, lock the shelter.
Woo-hoo.
He can hear us throwing fireballs inside the shelter. Guys, you're a waste in those fireballs. Wait, is he Irish?
No, he's Italian.
He's Irish now.
He's plumber.
Italian.
I know, but I just gave him a kind of Irish accent.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm a Mario.
There you go.
It's me, Mario, mate.
Oh.
Yeah, no, right? He's Australian.
All right, and the next three dudes that show up at the door.
Okay,
harder decision. You got BJ Blazkowicz from Wolfenstein, Duke Nukem.
Oh my god!
And the Doom guy, all the big beefers.
Well, I'm sure as shit I'm not killing the Doom guy.
He's coming in forever.
Well, I'm going to ask him what he wants, and he can take
those
options.
What do you want to do?
Yeah, it's up
to
you, man.
Hey,
yeah.
Come over here real quick.
Why did you even knock?
Here's the choices. I have to kill one of you. I have to let one of you in, and the other one we're just going to beat you up and take your stuff. I respect you. Look, which one do you want to be?
Yeah. Yeah, like,
I will let you have whatever you want. Hey, do you want to take out these guys with us? We'll take them out right now.
Yeah.
I'm
do you
not
want
letting
gorilla meat.
I don't care.
Yeah,
I have a lot of it. I have a ton. You can have all of it. I don't care.
You ever heard of Donkey Kong? He gone. I'm not letting BJ Blazkowicz in my shelter.
Yeah,
I just hate him.
He just kind of hits different, and I don't like him very much.
He's too douchey.
Yeah,
I just can't.
BJ versus Duke.
No,
you got to kill Duke Nukem, right?
I'm going to loot BJ, kill Duke, and Doom Guy is part of my crew now.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Right?
I'll never die.
Yeah, no, he's I'm not going to try to fight him or kill him.
No.
But if he's on my team, we let him in immediately.
Yeah.
You're part of the crew. Now beat him up.
All right, so the next crew of this is the next generation of beefers. Okay. We got Geralt from The Witcher,
okay.
Marcus Fenix from Gears of War, and Master Chief from Halo.
Ooh, this is tough. Okay, let's go through this. Geralt, he has magic.
I like don't want to kill him, but that's just because he's pretty.
Yeah, yeah. He's he would. Well, let's see.
You can't use any of Master Chief's stuff.
Yeah, you can't
loot
shoot
his 2,000-pound armor.
You get a sword.
That's true.
Yes.
You would get a laser sword, but you could get a chainsaw gun.
Here's mine. You can decide what you want. Mm-hmm. Geralt is in my crew. Here's why. Maybe this is a zombie situation, right? Maybe we just don't want to attract too much attention. The chainsaw gun and anything Master Chief has is going to be very loud. Mm-hmm. I feel like Geralt, we could go out and do raiding or looting or whatever. And he's got a sword, right? He could be quiet. He's got a little bit of magic.
Yeah.
We could do this under the radar. Mm-hmm. Because I don't have magic and I don't have a sword. I need someone who's going to help protect me and not draw attention. Master Chief, I'd probably just kill him. He's really? Too much competition. I can't have him around.
Competition? You think you're competing. You're at the level that you are competing with Master
No,
Chief.
No, that's the thing. So if I have a choice, he's got to get taken out because he will beat me every time.
Mm.
And then we're just going to beat up what's his face?
Marcus Fenix
and yeah,
you gotta loot Marcus because Marcus is just like the thing I like about all these guys though. Is
I just want that hat.
Are big talkers, so I'm happy for any of them to come in. Just yeah. You know, Master Chief would just sit on the
Master
couch.
Chief would be a good
quietly,
guy.
And like Geralt would just kind of sit there quietly. Yeah, I think that'd be nice.
Yeah,
So that's my choices.
Yeah, and you know, the longer you spend in a shelter with Geralt, the better because he's. He can't get it.
He doesn't have the disease.
Yeah,
you know he doesn't have it.
The disease, so
he
that's
can't
great.
Get it.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah.
He can't get it.
Yep.
He's not a carrier.
I think I would still like reverse him, though, because Master Chief is like in that armor and everything, so I almost trust him to get looted and not, you know.
If he's on your team.
Yeah.
And there's no way he can sit on any of your furniture, though.
Yeah.
Can he take the armor off?
I
can he let me borrow it?
No.
Can he let me get in it?
I don't think you can.
Can I take it for a spin?
I think Master Chief is literally twice your height.
He's
also
like
enormous.
Isn't he fused to it by now? I don't know.
Probably.
It's
just Tony Stark.
It's part of him now.
All right, our next one. This is the random grab bag. This is like weird.
No theme.
No theme because I wanted it to be random. Ash from Pokemon, the
he's
anime.
Out. He's dead. Kill him. What? Who else?
Who Cortana from Halo, the AI.
Oh.
And Bowser from Mario.
I want to keep Bowser.
You want to keep Bowser?
Big turtle man, yes.
Because she can have turtle soup after she finishes off all the monkey.
Yeah.
I'm thinking for the future.
Yeah, because
Danny's just that's her first thought on all of these. Some people are out there buying toilet paper and Danny is like looking at you and wondering how you taste with barbecue sauce.
Like no, he needs more. We need to get those muscles more.
I don't
developed.
Think you exercise enough. Yeah, no, you exercise too much. Yeah. Get out of here.
You
look gamey.
Tough.
You're very gamey.
You look gamey.
Oh,
that's why you're not in.
Yeah.
He's probably a little too gamey.
Why don't you try to run a little less, maybe eat a little more fat, and then get back to me.
Oh my god.
But you look like a
Ash
stream.
Is gamey.
Mm-hmm.
Ash and, is dead.
No,
Ash
I don't,
is, you guys
Ash
are both killing
what's
Ash.
What's he going to do for me?
Is Pikachu
nothing.
With him?
Does he have a Pokemon?
He has his full shitty set.
Oh,
of Pokemon.
We can eat Pokemon.
We can loot his stuff,
and
then
eat
we have
all
Pokemon.
Six of his Pokemon.
Ooh.
Danny's like, loot, eat. that's who I do.
Loot.
Obviously, we're keeping Cortana because she's inedible, so she's in.
So I guess
everyone
I guess
else,
not.
We just shoot you and
she's
eat you.
She's not going to cost me any food or anything. Like,
yeah, but I could also just unplug her and not feel bad about it.
Mm. Can you plug her back in?
She's like Master Chief's Tamagotchi.
Tamagotchi.
And he gets way too connected to her, obviously. He's way too attached. And like Halo 4 and 5 literally would not happen if he could just let go of this blue Tamagotchi.
He spent a whole $10 on that. Like.
Yeah, he spent 10 bucks on it. What do you want?
He's like, I'm invested.
Oh, give it up. Okay, so let's see. I would keep Cortana because she doesn't eat my food or use my toilet paper. I would kill Bowser to make some of that sweet turtle soup. I don't want him in my shelter. Those spikes will impale me at some point.
And
on
the once you hollow him out, the shell's going to be pretty comfy. Oh, like
I could sit in that.
Or
like
a cool
like
chair.
A gaming chair. Yeah.
Oh, you're right.
You could throw some.
I want to change my answer.
Take a cool chair.
Yeah, and then you can take.
For streaming from my followers. What's up, dudes?
just broadcasting here from my Bowser shell. And you have Donkey Kong's skin stretched over it, so it's like real soft and cuddly.
Oh, my God.
This is awesome. This is the primo gaming shelter.
This is the primo shelter.
Just made out of other gamers.
And then Ash, we're just going to beat him up, take his Pokeballs,
and eat him.
Yeah, he's like, what, a 14-year-old kid now? Yeah. Like, what's he going to do?
And you leave him just standing in the woods in his underpants, and you tell the last thing he hears before the vault door squeaks shut is like, these are going to be delicious.
Anyone ever is shutting? Anyone ever tasted a Pikachu? Gate door closed. He's out there like, no, he's been my friend for years.
Okay, this one's for the ladies. We've got Princess Peach from Mario, Samus Aran from Metroid.
Yep, she's on my team.
And Lara Croft from Lara Croft.
No, I want Samus.
So she's in.
She's so cool.
And if you have any like crevices or any places in the shelter you can't reach, she can just turn into a ball.
She can do her little ball jump.
Mm-hmm. Her she's and Mario are your plumbers.
Yeah.
They're always checking shit out. Wait, did Mario get... I think Mario got looted.
We looted Mario.
We took his plumbing
we
supplies.
We beat him up, yeah.
Yeah. I also had to beat them up because they're not going to hand it to you for free.
Yeah,
no, we beat up like all of them.
Oh, yeah. No, if you're looting them, you have to beat them up.
So
Bring out the tire iron, boys.
I assume you guys are killing Princess Peach. Jesus Christ. So you're beating Princess Peach to death with a tire iron.
Wait. No.
Lara Croft's going to die?
Yeah. Lara Croft is going to die.
I don't know, though. She has like a lot of survival gear.
She does have survival. Ooh, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
What does Peach even have?
A dress.
We don't need that.
And a perky attitude.
Samus isn't going to wear the She's
Princess
real gamey.
Princess meat? No, princess meat would be delicious because all they eat is like cakes and stuff.
Yeah, so she'd be like...
Mm-hmm. Okay. Wait.
Much closer
to
pork
be clear,
than deer.
We are now eating Princess Peach.
We've been eating everyone.
We think she might taste good.
Dude, this is
is happening?
This is the world of the coronavirus. You hear the on the shelter door, and you're like, your mouth starts salivating. You're like, boys, Uber Eats is here.
Pavlov effect. Yeah. Then knock on the door. You start salivating. I'm really hungry.
I don't even know what's on the other side, but I know I'm gonna eat it.
I am really glad that DoorDash has survived the apocalypse.
Your Dasher has arrived. Enjoy.
Oh, they sure have.
You're like, dinner's here.
That's not how it works. You don't eat the delivery person.
So you guys are keeping Samus, shooting Lara Croft and stealing her shit, and then shooting Peach and eating her shit.
I think that's what I'm... That's,
okay.
That's
this is the last one, and this one is rough.
Okay.
I'm sorry in advance. This is the real hard choices. So, you know, the jokes are done now, guys. And you have to make some hard choices because at the shelter door right now are Pikachu.
Okay.
I already ate him.
Or Ori. Oh, it's a different Pikachu.
He was okay.
Ori from Ori in the Blind Forest. And the character from Journey.
Oh, okay.
No.
Wait. What?
They're hard choices. Danny, the jokes are over.
No.
You have to make some calls now.
Remind me what the character for Journey looks like.
Okay, right there.
Oh, jeez.
I was like, are you serious right now? We took a picture of it.
I was thinking of a different game.
I know what Danny is bringing into the shelter.
What does everyone bring to the table if we were going to bring them in?
You can't. Pikachu's obviously going to get eaten, right? Unless he could power your shit.
That's true.
Oh, that's true. Endless electricity. Mm-hmm. So we will enslave him?
Yeah.
We're going to enslave
Pikachu. Feed him monkey meat for electricity.
Feed him the other Pokemon.
Yeah.
Eat Squirtle.
Oh, yeah.
Some Squirtle soup.
That'd be tight. What's better, Squirtle soup or Bowser soup?
Squirtle soup is better. Guaranteed.
Soup is such a good band name.
Squirtle soup. That is a good name.
It's like the veal of turtle soup. Because he's like the baby turtle, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's see.
Yeah.
Pikachu has no loot. We know that. Does right. Do any of these guys have any loot?
I don't know about Ori, but
what would Journey have?
Journey has the ability to turn on things with like a little chirp and can fly.
So it's like a it's like a clapper.
Yeah, basically like.
So we're enslaving somebody.
Yes. But the Journey.
It's either your light switch or the light generator.
The Journey character can also, I think, make you warm because they, like, when they are next to another Journey character.
So can Pikachu if he electrocutes you enough.
Well, I don't
want to
be electrocuted.
That's true.
Well, we just want to be warm.
Maybe I just want to be like. I just want, like, a dude in a cloak to sing at me. And I feel toasty.
How warm would an Ori coat be?
Ori's real small, so I don't know, man.
Can we make a coat out of Ori? Do we know the scale of Ori?
Whatever the scale is, you're not going to eat him or her. It's a him?
Oh.
I don't know. You're not going to eat it.
No.
No, you're not eating Ori.
You don't tell me what I'm going to eat.
You might make like a hot delicacy.
I eat anything now. Are you kidding me? The apocalypse is here. I'm hungry.
Check out this princess meat.
Yeah, I got princess meat.
I have gained so much weight because all the people that show up.
You should see the meat closet in this shelter. It is horrifying.
Honestly, people need to stop knocking on my door because I'm running out of space in the freezer.
I ran out of salt years ago.
I don't even know.
Yeah, like...
I think the Journey character sounds the most useful to have around.
Although Pikachu is a close second.
Yeah.
Nah.
I can imagine stealing the Journey
character. Can the Journey character talk?
No, they just sing. They do like a little chirp.
Oh, that's better than Pika Pika all the time. No, yeah. I'd kill Pikachu. I can't handle that.
Okay, what do we hope to get off of Ori, though? Like, what do we... why
companionship.
Just no, if we're looting.
Yeah.
If we're looting Ori.
Yeah.
I don't know.
All it has to offer.
Ori's out there. You kick her, because apparently she's the size of a soccer ball.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know. You kick her and
you're
like,
sorry,
like,
this is just the process.
What do you got? You're like rifling through. There's no pockets.
There's the fur. You're like picking them up by the legs and what's shaking.
What do you have?
What do you have? Come on, you little shit. I know you're holding out on me. this is bleak. We got to move on. Do you reindeer gasmic supernova?
You're gonna
eat
we'll
save that. You're going to eat
Yeah.
Yeah, come on. Realistically, what this has proven to us is that both of you are just going to eat anything that knocks on the door.
There's some selection process.
Yeah, a little bit, but like most of it's going in the vat.
But really, the ones we let into the party, we're just saving for later because we don't have room in the freezer.
You've like
come on in, come on in. When we're out of turtle meat, then squirtle meat, then we're going to eat the next one.
You've seen this in like fantasy fiction, this idea of like a perpetual pot. Have you heard of this? Have you seen it?
Mm-mm.
The idea, this is a thing. It's kind of it's an apocryphal rumor, but it was something that it'd go on for a year or two, but not literally forever. The idea that you have a stew pot that just constantly goes in a fantasy realm.
Oh, yeah.
This is a medieval trope that you've seen.
Yeah.
And they just keep adding ingredients, and anyone that stops at the inn can grab a scoop of the stew that's been cooking for years, essentially. That's what you guys have. You have the shelter door pot. Anything that knocks on the door is going into the pot. And it just like whatever
right
meat.
This way, please.
Just step into the kitchen.
Dice, dice, dice of destiny.
All right. Dice of Destiny is the way we close out every episode because it's awesome. We take a 20-sided dice that has 20 different game genres assigned to it. We roll to see what genre we'll play. We'll roll a 6-sided dice to see how much money we can spend. And then finally, we roll to determine who has to find a game for that price in that genre, choose it, play it, and review it. Last week, I rolled an adventure game for less than $30. And after a lot of looking, I arrived on this game called Curse of the Dead Gods.
It's spicy. By which metal band made this game?
Children of Bodom. No, I don't know, dude. It looks awesome though. It's a isometric kind of top down adventure type game. So it's got if you're familiar with Diablo, it's kind of got that same type of vibe. You're running through dungeons. You're fighting monsters. You're solving puzzles. Just a classic adventure game in that type of view, which I kind of appreciate. I think it's kind of a fun way. The last one I saw that was really fun was Transistor.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I love Transistor.
Yeah, they can do a lot of fun stuff with that 2.5D type of angle, and I absolutely love it. So yeah, I'm super looking forward to playing that.
Okay. You ready?
Ready to get coronavirus? All right, guys. If you want to play Dice of Destiny with us, you can always go online, 3bitgamershow.com/dice, and there's a cool little roller that picks the genre for you, picks the game for you, and the price, and then you can jump online and play with us. Also, in our Discord channel, which you guys should all be part of if you're regular listeners, our Discord channel has a Dice of Destiny sub-chat?
Is that what we call it?
Yeah, I don't know what it's called, but where we all play Dice of Destiny so you can play along with us if you'd like. This is a really cute music video. There's like a dog in it.
Aww.
That's the only reason it's cute, because the dog? What about the guy?
Eh.
He was very handsome.
Could leave him. Could leave him. All right. That does it for us for this week. I'm JD, logging off.
This is Peterson, going AFK.
And Danny Powers, BRB.
Peterson Productions.
Oh, yeah.